Dakota Childs found out with about 1:45, 1:50 remaining in the fourth quarter with an offensive foul and then a technical foul. But Alta did not have enough to stay in this one tonight with Bingham to get our final score. Bingham Miners 54. The Alta Hawks back to Bingham High School, get our final score. The Bingham Miners 54 and the Alta Hawks 48. A big win for Bingham. They moved up 5-0 in region play heading into the second half of region. And a big win tonight against Alta. The fourth quarter was the biggest test tonight for Bingham. And it's something I think will springboard them as they continue to get better throughout this year. Jolie Childs fouled out by 1:50 remaining in this game with an offensive foul and then a technical foul. And in the fourth quarter, it looked like this could be Alta's game. It was 43-43 heading into the fourth, but Alta could not continue moving in the fourth quarter. Only scored 5 points in the quarter. And Bingham got things moving. Bingham was down the stretch, offensive rebounds. Jordan Matthews had big rebounds. But the story of the second half was Mr. Holman, 15 points in the game. Almost all of those coming in the second half. Yoli Childs at 17 and a half did not score in the second half. It was Jared Holman getting things done offensively, also defensively, protecting the bucket, got a number of blocks, altered shots. Roberts had a shot at Alford down the baseline late in the fourth quarter, but it was Holman that altered that shot, and Alta could not get things moving. To speak about Alta, we can play, but a tough loss tonight against the Bingham Miners. Bingham moves on, 5-0 in region play. Our Dodge player in the game is going to go to Jordan Holman. You have got to win games in the second half, and Holman did that, especially without Yoeli Childs in the paint on both sides of the floor in the fourth quarter. Got the job done as Bingham held Alta to only 5 points in the fourth quarter. Again, our final score, the Bingham Miners 54, the Alta Hawks 48. Our Nudge player of the game, Jared Holman, with over 500 points.
Another guy off the bench was a fourth guy in double figures. He was if you had a player of the game that came off the bench in terms of the sub of the game, I think you'd give it to Jared Holman, wouldn't you, Lance?
Oh, you'd have to. You see here on the highlights him making a nice little drop step move right there for a layup. He played a great game.
So again, there's Holman right there, and he's coming across to the screen there and spins back into the paint. A nice little move there. Holman with 12 off the bench. The big guy for Overland had a pretty good game. Drawn
4-4-3-3-2-2-1-1-0.
Let's get it started in here.